Ant and Elephant by Spike Milligan. Said a tiny ant to the elephant, "Mind how you tread in this clearing." But alas, cruel fate, she was crushed by the weight of an elephant hard of hearing. Mashed Potato Love Poem by Sidney Hoddes. If I ever had to choose between you and a third helping of mashed potato, whipped lightly with a fork, not whisked, and a little pool of butter melting in the middle, I think I'd choose the mashed potato. But I choose you next. Of Pygmies, Palms and Pirates by Mervyn Peake. Of pygmies, palms and pirates, of islands and lagoons, of blood-bespottled frigates, of crags and octoroons, of whales and broken bottles, of quicksands cold and grey, of ullages and dottles, I have no more to say. Of barley, corn and furrows, of farms and turf that heaves above such ghostly burrows as twitch on summer eves, of fallow land and pasture, of skies both pink and grey, I made a statement last year and have no more to say. The Hero by Robert Graves. Slowly, with bleeding nose and aching wrists, after tremendous use of feet and fists, he rises from the dusty schoolroom floor and limps for solace to the girl next door, boasting of kicks and punches, cheers and noise, and far worse damage done to bigger boys. Too Fast to Live, Too Young to Work by Mark Jones. I'm the James Dean of the Dole Queue. You've got to admire my cheek, trying to work out how to live fast and die young on 17.50 a week. A legend in my own cubicle, all alone, never one of the mob. I'm the James Dean of the Dole Queue, a rebel without a job. The Pretty Young Thing by Anonymous. A pretty young thing from St. Paul's wore a newspaper gown to a ball. The dress caught fire and burned her attire, front page, sporting section and all. 3, 2, 1.